ఓం శ్రీ గణేశాయ నమః. ఓం శ్రీ మహాసరస్వత్యై నమః. అట్ ది వెరీ అవుట్సెట్ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు ఎక్స్టెండ్ మై హార్ట్ ఫెల్ట్ గణేష్ చతుర్థి గ్రీటింగ్స్ టు ఆల్ ది వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ సివిఆర్ ఛానల్ గ్రూప్. ఇట్స్ ఇండీడ్ ఎ ప్రివిలేజ్ టు హ్యావ్ విత్ అస్ అన్ ఎమినెంట్ పర్సనాలిటీ, డాక్టర్ రాఘవ సతీష శర్మ గారు. ఇట్స్ ఎ రేరిటీ, ఫర్ హీ కంబైన్స్ within himself a deep spiritualist as well as a person who is dedicated to the social cause, for which he was awarded numerously by various agencies, both national and international also. And to have such an eminent personality on this auspicious occasion is indeed a divine privilege. And it's, we are not taking much time because we would like to invite the personality to all the viewers. Namaste Andy. We welcome you to this a deep discussion on the tattva of Ganesha, that is the philosophical essence and spiritual essence of the Ganesha tattva, as we are celebrating this festival. So we welcome you to this discussion. And at the outset, we would like to know from you as to what Ganesha essentially means.
First of all, I'm very thankful that this kind of an auspicious festival of Ganesha Chaturthi,
yes,
which given me an opportunity to share a little words by me to enter the society and city, and as well as where the,
yes,
hands will go of CVR news.
Definitely, it will reach worldwide.
So I'm very happy for to be here with you, especially.
Equally so, sir. Equally so.
So I'll also give my wishes, blessings to this CVR entire group.
Thank you.
From top to bottom, from chairman, team of crew, team of technical,
yes,
team of other supports,
yes,
and everyone. And coming to the point of tattva of Ganesha is nothing but a small child.
Oh, that's really wonderful. You have put everything in one nutshell. This is really very nice.
So we can find out in even our homes also that children will do the same kind of
naughty things
which completely equal to the Ganesha.
Correct.
Why? Because Ganesha Udbhava has been done on Chaviti, that's called Vinayaka Chaviti. And the Ganesha, he started from the childhood only, he started by showing him what everything he is.
Yes, exactly.
He used to call as a Gajasura. Then it was turned up on Chaviti, Ganesha has been Udbhava, Vinayaka has been Udbhava because of Parvati. So that is the reason, from that day onwards we are celebrating the great festival of in our country,
yes,
which is called Ganesha Chaturthi, in Telugu Vinayaka Chaviti. So Ganesha tattva is very 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 childish. Whatever he need he will do, whatever he want he will do that, and everything wherever he want to go he will go.
Yes,
there is no barricades of him.
He has no restrictions.
No restrictions at all. And the same time we used to call as a Vigna Rajadipa.
Exactly. That's nice.
Why? Because if any karma, any kind of kriya, any kind of things, if anybody will start, the first they will do this Vignesha Puja.
Puja. Ganapati Puja.
Ganapati Puja they call. So after that only they will move forward.
Yes.
That is the importance of him.
And the wonder of the wonders is that even for performing Ganesha Vrata also we do Ganapati Puja.
Exactly. So why? Because even for him also he,
yes,
is a, he kept a barricade that first you do that, then only you come to
that
me.
Is the tradition.
Tradition.
Exactly.
And it's only in India.
That's it. That is
it's
the
only in India
only.
That we are giving some information that there is any rules and regulations for each and everything, that what we need to do before that we have to make this Ganapati Puja for everything.
This is mandatory.
Mandatory.
Mandatory. Yeah. సో వీఆర్ వెరీ హ్యాపీ దట్ స్వామి హ్యాస్ పుట్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఇన్ ఎ బ్రీఫ్ నట్షెల్ బై సేయింగ్ దట్ గణేష ది లార్డ్ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ఏ స్మాల్ చైల్డ్ ఏ చైల్డ్ విత్ ఇట్స్ నైవ్ ఎంట్రీ ఇన్ టు దిస్ వరల్డ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెసెస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫీలింగ్స్ బట్ ఇట్ రిమైన్స్ అన్కనెక్టెడ్ టు ద వరల్డ్ లైక్ పద్మపత్రం ఇవాంభస దో స్టేయింగ్ ఇన్ దట్ పాండ్ ద లోటస్ ఈస్ నాట్ అటాచ్ టు ద పాండ్ ఇట్ స్టేస్ అవే ఫ్రమ్ ఇట్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ ఇట్స్ సోర్స్ విత్ ఇన్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ వే ద చిల్డ్రన్ విల్ స్టే ఇన్ ద వరల్డ్ బట్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ అటాచ్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ కండిషన్ దే ఆర్ నాట్ కెప్ట్ ఇన్ అ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ బాండేజ్ లైక్ హౌ ది ఎల్డర్స్ డూ వెన్ దే గ్రో అప్ సో దిస్ ఈస్ రియలీ అ వండర్ఫుల్ ఇంట్రొడక్షన్ ఇన్ టు దిస్ తత్వ ఆఫ్ గణేష అండ్ వీ గో ఫర్దర్ విత్ స్వామి టు ఆస్క్ హిమ్ అబౌట్ అదర్ థింగ్స్ లైక్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది ఫిలాసాఫికల్ ఇంపోర్ట్ స్వామి ఆఫ్ సెలబ్రేటింగ్ దిస్ గణేష చతుర్థి
యూ వాంట్ మీ టు టెల్ అబౌట్ గణేష చతుర్థి ఆర్
ఫిలాసాఫికల్ ఇంపోర్ట్ లైక్ హౌ వై గణేష చతుర్థి సెలబ్రేటెడ్ ఆన్ ద చవితి అండ్ వన్ మోర్ థింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది ఫిలాసఫీ ఆఫ్ దిస్ గణపతి తత్వ
See, basically this Ganesha Chaviti has been given information that Jagan Mata, Parvati Devi, Parvati. When she given a birth of Gajasura, then it was turned into the other Vinayaka. And I know that everybody know about the story of how it has been converted into the
Gajasura. Second
manifestation. So, after that, when that Udbhava, which called Vinayaka Chavati, then he started, the way he is having that Rupa, Akruti and everything, he used to play that everything. So, on that special day, when he was gone through some kind of any, games and all.
Yes.
So, having some food and all. When the things are happened in a different kind of a negative mode, then there is a moon, I mean Chandradhipati. He used to laugh on him.
Yes, yes. Seeing his different form.
By different kind of stomach and everything, he laughed on him.
Okay.
So, after that, again the problem came to the Ganesha to go on some kind of a negative part. On that, exactly on that day, on that time, those who will see on Chandra.
So, they will also incur the same thing.
Exactly. Okay. They will be face a lot of issues, lot of problems, lot of difficulties if you see the Chandra.
Chandra on that day. Okay.
So, again Chandra gone to the Sri Mahavishnu and he requested like anything.
Okay.
Then, obviously she is a sister of Sri Mahavishnu and Sri Mahavishnu went to the Parvati and he requested her that there is a festival, everybody will see and nobody can't stay without seeing a Chandra.
Yes, invariably we see.
It's invariably. So you have to see kind of some kind of a solution that nobody should face any problems and struggles.
Some parihara.
Parihara, parishkara, whatever it is. So then Jagan Mata, Parvati Devi has given information to entire the universe that those who do this puja of Vinayaka Chaviti, after that there will be a Vrata Kalpa. Yes, there is a process of Vinayaka Chaviti Vrata Kalpa, puja vidhanam, everything and after that they have to go through the story of each and everything, whatever I said right now. Each and everything, whatever the Vinayaka, Udbhava, everything. So, after that, they have to take the blessings of Ganesha. Then, if they will see the moon also, they won't face any problem.
This is really nice.
So, this kind of vidhanam, especially for only for Ganesha, no any other god having this kind of situation.
This is nice.
Even Satchanarayana Vratam also, if anybody will feel that I need to present this Satchanarayana Vrata, they have to do that. If not, they will see the some kind of a situations.
Yes.
But no god is there that on that auspicious day, on that festival day, on that god, we have to do Vratakalpa Vidhanam, Vratakalpa Puja and after that everything and especially we need to give the prasadam of Kudumulu and after that we have to go for stories, then only we will ఎలిజిబుల్ టు టేక్ ద బ్లెస్సింగ్స్. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ బ్లెస్సింగ్స్ ఓన్లీ వీ కెన్ కమ్ అవుట్ వితౌట్ ఎనీ ప్రాబ్లమ్, అదర్వైజ్ ఎవ్రీబడి విల్ బి ఇన్ ద సూపర్. నో, గాడ్ ఈస్ హ్యావింగ్ దీస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ టర్మ్స్ అండ్ కండిషన్స్. హీ ఈస్ ద ఓన్లీ, బికాజ్ హీ ఇస్ ఎ చైల్డ్.
దట్ ఇస్
వాట్ ఎవర్ ద పేరెంట్స్ will expect something from child,
exactly.
Then child will put a condition, if you give me then I will do whatever you want,
yes.
If you won't give I will,
yes.
So this kind of tattva, the same, if you do puja, if you do go through the story, if you do kudumos and everything to me, then I will excuse, otherwise I won't.
I'll take care. That is nice. Now, once again, Swamiji has been really wonderful in exposing this kind of the behavior of the boyishness of Ganesha in warding off the evil which we incur by looking at the moon on that particular day of Ganesha Chaturthi, because the legend and the mythology says that anyone who looks at the moon on that particular day without performing the traditional puja and the other narration and going through the exact story of the avirbhava of Ganesha, they will definitely incur a kind of sin and the whole year will have so many troubles waiting for them. But as Swami really has said in a wonderful way, just as boys demand something for something else, Ganesha also has put a condition. If you go through this process, you will be cleared of this obstacle and you will become free from such a trouble. So this is nice to hear from you, Swami.
Basically, in our forms also, if you give a small children,
yes.
If you give a bicycle for me, then I will go for studies. Yes.
Something will be there.
This will be, this kind of a conditions we will see.
Condition and relation will be
everything.
There.
Yes. So obviously, whether he will go for thoroughly or not, parents will give everything to the children.
Definitely.
But even then, children nowadays, if you give, then I will do. That if you give, then I will study.
Correct.
This kind of tattva is nothing but Ganesha.
Ganesha. This is nice.
Very simple.
And now let us not waste time in thinking about these things. Let us take deeper questions, because Swamiji is available here. He will answer us he will give us the deeper import of what Ganesha is really is. So now we will go with something very deep. Like it is said that Ganesha is an embodiment of pranava. They say prana shakti, the life energy, when it combines with vakara shakti of Shiva and shakti, it becomes pra, and va becomes pranava. That pranava is nothing but an identification or symbolization of our Ganesha. So let us ask Swami as to how this concept of pranava has been identified with Lord Ganapati, because he will be the best person to answer us. Swami, will you please give us the import of this tattva of pranava?
Actually, this pranava has come from Shiva only.
Shiva, exactly.
Because he is the only do in entire of Mukkoti Devata, in entire of the
domain of the gods.
He is the only person who can make pranavanadam.
Pranavana, exactly.
He can only make pranava tandavam.
He can only make
everything of this laya.
Laya is possible.
So, okay. Shiva and Parvati, when this both has been decided to make some kind of an assurance to the bhakta, that whatever they perform in their life,
exactly,
it should not be get any kind of an obstacle and struggles and hurdles. For that they have given a beautiful solution, Ganesha. So it is their only creation to make some kind of pranava. From that pranava nadam has been become Omkara Shabdam.
This is good.
Actually, people will think first Omkaram has come, then no.
Yes.
The Omkara Ninadam has been come from Pranavanadam, has been Layakara Kudu. We used to say,
yes, he is the embodiment of
Jagan Mata, she is a Parvati. When this Pranava, they can only do the Pranava Shabdam, they can only do the Pranava Natyam, they can only do everything.
Yes.
They are the Layakarakas. So they have given the biggest solution for each and every person. Whatever you perform, first you do this. For that, this both only created this entire Vinayaka episode.
Oh, this is really truly magnificent for me, because స్వామీజీ హెస్ గివెన్ ఏ డిఫరెంట్ ఇంటర్ప్రిటేషన్ టు ది వెరీ ఆరిజిన్ ఆఫ్ గణేష. హితర్టు వి వర్ థింకింగ్ దట్ ఓన్లీ ద ప్రణవ స్వరూప ఈస్ ది ఎంబాడిమెంట్, బట్ స్వామీజీ హెస్ మేడ్ ఇట్ వెరీ క్లియర్ దట్ హౌ ద ప్రణవ ఆరిజినేట్స్ అండ్ హీ సేస్ దట్ లార్డ్ శివ అండ్ శక్తి దే హవ్ బీన్ రియలీ బెనవలెంట్ టువర్డ్స్ అస్ ఇన్ గ్రాంటింగ్ ఏ బూన్ కాల్డ్ గణేష. గణేష ఈజ్ ఇండీడ్ ఎ బూన్ టు ఎవ్రీవన్ టు వార్డ్ ఆఫ్ ది అబ్స్టకల్స్. We are passing through a world of duality wherein so many obstacles come to us every moment. Moment to moment we have to chase the obstacles, we have to get over the hurdles and we have to get along our path of life. So, as Swami says, the Ganesha Tattva is indeed a kind of boon to everyone, varam, it is said, boon to everyone to ward off this problem of obstacles. So this is a new interpretation which Swami has given today. Like how I have been telling, we have to explore further so as to get such wonderful answers from Swami. And now let us go into the tattva of yoga. The Upanishad very clearly says that tvam mooladhara sthitosi nityam, always as ever the Lord Ganesha is stationed in that Mooladhara Chakra. As we all know, in yogic path we have the Shat Chakras: Mooladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipuraka, Anahata, Vishuddha, Agna, and the Sahasrara is the culmination or the meeting point of Shiva and Shakti. That is the be and end of everything. Once you attain to that spiritual energy level, then the cycle of birth and death which was chasing us will come to a halt. And we become one with that universal spirit. That is the highest state of existence. That is the Parama Pada. So in this aspect, let us ask Swami as to why Ganesha is positioned at the Mooladhara Chakra. And what is the yogic significance of such a positioning? Swami, will you be kind enough to give us an idea regarding this?
See, why it has come in one place?
One place.
Whatever you given a beautiful information to the audience and public and everything, top to bottom, whatever the chakras we have, entire everything has to come in one place in one day.
Oh.
Yoga. Whatever we work, whatever we do, whatever we receive, whatever we give, wherever we go, whatever it is will be happen. But one day we will come in one position where we can we sit one place where we can't go anywhere. We have to be there only. The person, whatever he is till 60, after 60 he is different.
It's totally different.
What is yoga? Yoga means there are several meanings up there.
Exactly, Swami.
Several meanings up there.
Several.
Ganesha Yoga Mudra is whatever he shows that. He is sitting one place, as you said. He is showing that whatever that there is a Ganapati, different kind of people may say idols, but they don't have any information about that. Natya Ganapati, Vaidya Ganapati, Sangeeta Ganapati, Kala Ganapati, several things are there.
Several.
But finally, he will stay in one place. The Moola Chakra, Moolam is important for everyone. Where we are staying and sitting and standing, that comes to one place finally.
That Moola is the ultimate thing.
Ultimate is, we need to see that where we are standing. That means Moola Dhara means, whatever top to bottom we have chakras, it can't go anywhere without our feet.
Yes, that is the, that right. Holds everything.
So, in Yoga Mudra, why Ganesha was there and he showed me, no, he was so much of stomach, that is, no. Entire Bhanda, Bhanda is there and he is showing that everything is in me, everybody will come to me, everybody will do everything, right?
Yes.
So, earlier, today, small Ganapatis people are taking,
yes.
But before with the turmeric they used to do the Ganapati and used to do puja.
Haridra Ganapati.
Haridra Ganapati, right? Without that, విల్ దే డూ ఎనీథింగ్?
నెవర్ నెవర్. హరిద్రా గణపతి ఇస్ ది రియల్ గణపతి,
రైట్? దట్ ఈస్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ. సో దట్ ముద్ర, దట్ యోగా ఇస్ ద రియల్ గణపతి. దట్ హరిద్రా గణపతి ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ యోగా, యోగ ముద్ర. వాట్ ఎవర్ యు ఐడల్స్ యు సీ, మేజర్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ 10 out of 9 will show that he will sit somewhere and he will bless to everyone. That's that nice. Is the final stage of yoga, where we will go one corner, we will stay there, we will sit there, we will tell everything, we will do everything, we will take everything.
Nice.
That means wherever you go, but finally you will come to me.
That is the thing.
The mula is very clear that you are depending on me. Yes. You are coming to me.
Coming to
you need me.
Yes.
So you have to be with me.
Oh, this is nice for me.
So whatever we are, finally we have to go and touch his feet only.
That's true.
So Mooladhara Chakram is very important. Even our families also. Whatever I am today, whatever I am, even there is no choice of showing that I am so and so without my surname.
Definitely. You are right, Swami.
Right. Without my parents, I am not there.
Nothing. Nowhere.
Without Mooladhara, where I am?
Oh.
Without Mooladhara, what is there? Without Mooladhara, where is the Bhubhanda? Without Mooladhara, where is the Chakra? So, all together in his only, he is there. So, that is the reason he will show what is the importance of the Mooladhara. Oh,
this is very nice, Swami. Dear audience, today we are hearing something really golden. Be assured, because these words you don't get anywhere else. Swami has been telling that whatever we do in life, right from the birth to the end of our life, everything comes to conclusion only with a particular entity, and that entity is the moolam of everything, and that entity is none other than Lord Ganesha. Swami has been stressing on the point that whatever we do must come to that only. So when it has to come to that, why not be with that now itself? In Bhagavad Gita there is a word which says ihaiva.
Yes,
right now.
Exactly.
Ihaiva.
I'm just recollecting that.
Thank you, Swami. Our minds are working on the synchronous wave, so we both are sharing the same thoughts. I'm very happy.
Yeah.
So it is like that. And now let us take some more information regarding such spiritual things from Swami. Now we have seen that the yogic domain is one such where only the subtle phenomenon is expressed and experienced, and that phenomenon has been amply exemplified by Swami. Now we go to the sociological aspect of Ganesha. Now we see in this world of chaos, everything is going in a different way. So we need to find a force which can unify everything. And as you all understand that even in physics also, there is a kind of experimentation going on with the International Society of Theoretical Physicists at Trieste in Italy to unify all the grand forces of the universe. They say that there are 4 fundamental forces in this whole universe, not this world but whole universe. That is the strong nuclear force, weak nuclear force, electromagnetic force and gravitational force. These are the 4 fundamental forces which govern the entire universe. So that way there is a kind of unification going on in the world, not only materialistically but even spiritually. So can we ask Swami whether such a kind of unification at the spiritual level could be called as Ganesha? Can we call that spiritual unification as Ganesha, Swami? What is your idea about this grand unification of everything that is going on in this world? Can Ganesha unify everything?
See, whatever you are telling, 100% I will accept.
That's true.
Whatever you have given, the message of the 4 fundamentals is very good. And it is universally, it's very good information, and whatever the people are receiving from you, it's also very good. For a while of a minute.
Definitely.
Whatever this universe are showing, this kind of nuclear,
these
kind of things.
Material forces.
Material forces, whatever it is there.
Only gross forces.
Right.
Yes.
Hundreds years of before, 100 years of before.
Okay.
Nothing is there.
Thing.
For people, nothing is there. But if they will focus intellectually, if they will focus, it is there.
It is there.
Today, whatever you are seeing towers, earlier it is Dvajasthambhas in our temples.
Oh, that's wonderful, Swami. That is true. That is true.
It's whatever.
Yes, Dvajasthambhas.
Dvajasthambhas. Is it almost the towers of every pilgrim will work as a tower.
Definitely.
And Sikhara.
Shikharam. Correct.
Shikharas.
Shikharas.
Kalasas.
Kalashas.
There are very long back only it has been started working. Now the people are looking into the science.
Definitely. They are looking through a kind of grosser medium, and to some extent only they will understand, because their eyes are very gross.
Exactly.
Our sages are very subtle.
Exactly.
It is like that.
Whatever today we are finding through in scientific way. In Bhaugolik Shastra, whatever the things are
physical
thing. Atmosphere, whatever we are finding now, it was implemented very long back already.
So correct, sir.
See, the fundamentals, whatever is there, God has created very long back. Just we are sharing few things right now.
When you are saying this, I remember a quotation from Veda.
Yeah.
You are really right, Swami, because our ancestors, the great rishis, they could visualize the truth as such.
Exactly.
Not like the scientists through some instrumentation. No, via medium, direct seeing only.
The media has come now.
Media, it has come
now. It has come.
So, our sages have said one thing. Balena prithvi tishtati, balena va antariksham.
Exactly.
There is a force which is holding together the earth and the universe together. So that force, now Newton has named it as gravitation.
Gravitation, exactly.
It was there long back, but it came to the the notice of the world just some 200-300
years.
See, I'll
tell
back.
You in this last statement of this my thought.
Yes.
Everything has been there already, just we are receiving and producing.
Exactly. So as Swami says, nothing is an invention, it's only a discovery.
Exactly.
Not an invention, it has already been invented. Only discovery.
That's all.
It's already there,
it is there.
Under a cloth. Just if you remove the veil, it is there.
In very easy to way to the understand people, I will say one more.
Swami.
If my parents have given a beautiful constructed house to me, tomorrow I will give it to my children.
Yes, it will pass it on.
Right. The same way, hundreds of years before only, everything has been created, everything has been done, which we have received. We have just made some kind of a polish, we have just made some kind of a different atmosphere, different appearance. Now we are showing to the people that this has been done it.
This is as if it is something very new.
New.
Okay.
So it's a very old information which we are giving a new way of presentation. That's all.
Exactly.
So all these towers are previous is there. This entire kind of a scientific everything. Now we are using instruments. Yes. At that time, that is the Gnana Sampatti which has given so much to the entire the earth.
That's true.
Just because of Gnana Sampatti.
Gnana.
Because the only this Pudami is only have that kind of a power. Only this Bharatavani is having that kind of a power.
That's
this Bharatavani has given unbelievable sources to us.
This is true, Swami. Today you have really been ecstatic in telling that the glory of this land is really so much that we cannot express in mere words. Today, Swami has been really in a different mood, because he is trying to recollect to us the glory of what Bharata was, and what we know about Bharata today is completely different. We have to explore our roots so as to get in touch with the thought of the sages and the rishis. And really, Swami, as you have really said, everything was already there.
There is exactly everything
point,
is there.
At this point,
we are started looking into the serious mode, and we have done it. Now also our Prime Minister started the previous things, everything to build again for the society.
Society, exactly.
You can take from Kashi.
Yes, Kashi was there already.
It is there, which has been Yes. No, not notified properly, okay. Which has been notified properly and made everything very clearly what is Varanasi.
Yes. Now he has brought, he has made the significance more evident.
Exactly. Evident. So, okay. We have already so much of powerful weapons like a Jnana Sampatti has been different kind of rupas and different kind of ways. So, that is we have received and we are giving to the society, we are giving to the country in a different manner.
Oh, this is really so nice of you, Swami. Really, the time is flying like anything. We were really not aware that the time is flying. But really, as today we have heard so many things, so wonderful, so subtle, so philosophical, so spiritual, so native of you. And really, we thank you so much for coming over here and giving a new interpretation of what this festival is. Because our children, we have to pass this information to the posterity, and that's our responsibility. And people like you give the real interpretation into the phenomenon of this festival, and that should be carried on forever. So with these words, we come to the conclusion of this program, and we once again thank Swami, and we really admire him for his sharing of the thoughts, which are so wonderful. Thank you, Swami. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So this brings us to the end of this beautiful discussion on this auspicious day. May everyone celebrate Ganesh Chaturthi gloriously. May the blessings of Ganesha be upon everyone. Om Sri Ganeshaya Namaha. Tat Sat. Jai Jai Ganesha, Jai Jai Jai.